Hi guys, so I just watched Howard the Duck and I don't want to do this anymore. What was this? How did this happen? Who? What? How? What? People said that with the Star Wars prequels, this is why you don't give George Lucas complete creative control. We should have known. We should have known. Howard the Duck came out way before the Star Wars prequels, and that was the writing on the wall. What happened here? What was this? It just... this is definitely a creative vision. This is clearly something that someone had belief in. And actually, I say George Lucas, but it wasn't directed by George Lucas, but it was his project. This is a bizarre oddity. I'm sure that some of you might have seen it. Those of you who haven't, good for you, I think. Duck tits. More than once, we get duck tits. Could you believe this film was a financial failure? Who knew? Who was this for? That's the most confusing thing, is that this was put together with like the idea of being like the next big summer blockbuster. George Lucas had done Star Wars, he had done Indiana Jones. It was like, this is the next big thing. Duck tits. Woo! What? How has this movie happened? This is an unpleasant movie. It's the world that you see in this movie is an unple you don't want to be there. It's weird and surreal. It's so 80s. It's so 80s. The animatronics of Howard, which is like, they're clever. They're really, like, for the time, groundbreaking. I think this was the first sort of really fully functioning animatronic sort of suit, but it still looks weird and they're kind of cheap, even though I'm sure it wasn't. It's got this horrible kind of like Garbage Pail Kids feel to it. So yeah, not good. It's amazing that in a couple of years, similar technology was used for the Ninja Turtles so much more effectively. But essentially, yeah, this is a confused, weird movie. I was gonna say it doesn't know what it wants to be, but it does know what it wants to be. It has a vision and it goes for it. What it doesn't know is who it wants to appeal to, because some of it is like, oh, this is a wacky, family kind of like movie, and the other side is duck tits and gritty film noir and Howard the Duck working in a sex club and bestiality interspecies sex, and then at the end a horrific like body horror alien, like it's, oh, it's so weird. It's just weird. And you've got Lea Thompson, who, like, she was in two incredible 80s fantasy movies. One of them was Back to the Future. The other one was the other Back to the Future movie, because this was not. Yeah, it's just a bizarre movie. And what do I like? I can't. The alien, the overlord at the end is stop motion beauty. It's not worth watching the whole film for that. Just skip the last 5 minutes, because it's a stop motion creature designed by Phil Tippett, who did the stop motion for RoboCop and for Empire Strikes Back. Absolute special effects genius. I love that. But like the body horror that leads up to that is really, it's scary. And duck tits. Did I say duck tits in a summer blockbuster movie? Oh, it's so weird. I don't like this. It's just odd. I'm done now. I don't even know what the next movie is. But I need a good movie. I need to wash this taste out of my mouth. Yeah, I'll see you on the next episode.